Questions for Al?
Al, it seems like this is the same place we've been every four or five games, go through the ups, and then a game like this happens where the turnovers, missed shots, those things seem to be a similar pattern. Are you guys feeling this pattern in the locker room? Do you just treat these games as just individual losses? How does that resonate inside the locker room?
I feel like today we moved the ball, you know, well. We had 27 assists. The 14 turnovers. But in the past, you feel a certain way about some of these games. This was different. I would really have to, you know, look at the film and stuff. But I just think that they had some really timely offensive rebounds, kickouts, and hit some threes that really, you know, got to us. And despite all that, I feel like we were kind of there. I'm not going to group it with all the other stuff because I was a little encouraged with some of the ball movement offensively. It's definitely, you know, tough. You know, I felt like we had a chance coming into this game, and, those threes that they kept hitting, really, really hurt us.
When they're hitting those threes and you guys are coming down and missing a bunch, I mean, there were some times you were going back and forth, but you were still missing a bunch. Do you get caught up at all in the trying to answer versus running your offense, or how does that kind of play out on the floor?
Yeah, that's a good question. I think sometimes you can get caught up in that a little bit. But for the most part, I think that when that happened, you know, we try to get an easy basket up the floor. And if not, we did try to run some offense. So, you know, I felt like, you know, we were trying to, you know, do some of those right things. I just think that those offensive rebounds, like, there was just a few there that, you know, it was just kind of there, 50-50 balls that we've been good at. And we just didn't come up with those. And those add up in games like this, give them certain confidence. And that's what happened tonight, in my view. I mean, like I said, I have to look at the film, but that's from what I'm feeling right now from the game.
Thanks.
When you talk about not getting those balls, is that an effort thing, did you feel like, or just sometimes rough bounces?
Unfortunate. You know, there's going to be some unfortunate, but I think that there's, you know, there's times that it's like, you know, you against me and who wants it more, you know, type thing. We didn't come up with those, or sometimes it was, you know, a couple of our guys and just miscommunication and, you know, just didn't get it and things like that. They shoot a lot of threes, so there's going to be a lot of long rebounds, and it's kind of weird how the ball bounces sometimes. So I know that can be tough sometimes too.
Jason's having a tough time shooting, you know, for much of the season, but particularly the last couple of weeks, especially from three. Does he appear to be like pressing you a little bit? Is there things you can do, whether it be freeing him up? I mean, a lot of these were open tonight, but freeing him up for open looks, or even sitting down talking to them about, you know, where his mind is at, or like as a veteran, is there other ways to help, I guess, when a guy's kind of struggling? And obviously, you know, he's a capable shooter. He's shown over and over he can do it.
No question. I personally don't worry about Jayson. He's a scorer. We're going to continue to encourage him to be aggressive, to play his game. There's obviously a lot that he has to handle. He has to make sure that he's passing the ball when he's doubled. The ball's in his hands a lot of the times. He has to shoot it at different times. And all the attention of other teams are usually, you know, towards him and Jalen. So, he'll continue to stay aggressive. I know he'll continue to put in the work, and I'm not worried about it.
Had a few straight games where you shot the ball well. Just wondering if you're feeling anything different with the ball coming off your hand or getting better looks.
I think it's a combination of, you know, being able to get in the gym and kind of be more constant and consistent. You know, coming back after being out for a week from COVID, you know, I felt like I didn't get a chance to kind of prepare like I normally do, and I was kind of thrown into games, and everybody was dealing with that. So I just you know, felt like, you know, once I was able to get home, like all that stuff kind of blow over and start, you know, working. I feel like I'm back in a better rhythm more than anything. So, you know, just continuing that and you know, just keeping that going.
You guys were already down two starters tonight, and then Jayson and Grant were in foul trouble most of the night. How challenging is that to navigate?
It is very challenging. You know, in a game like tonight, obviously, you know, we miss Rob a lot and his presence and Marcus, you know, the things that he brings, those intangibles. And then, yeah, it doesn't help when, you know, when Jason's in foul trouble like that, it kind of changes the way that, you know, that he has to play and things like that. Obviously, Grant as well, he's been playing really well for us. So, but despite all that, I mean, you know, you always kind of have to find ways to get it done. You know, in this league, you're not always going to be healthy. You're not always going to have, there's different things that happen throughout the game. And this was a game that I felt like, you know, that we should have won. We give them credit, but, you know, with what we had, I feel like we should have won.
Terry hit the dagger. And I mean, you've seen him do that plenty of times from the other side, yeah. But also he, a lot of smiles. He stuck his tongue out at the bench at one point. How was he able to get so free tonight? Be able to play so freely.
Yeah, well, Terry, you know, he has continued to get better as a player. And I've been following him, and it's just, I just been impressed because, you know, some guys, they reach a certain point or a certain level, and they kind of taper off or stop necessarily working. But Terry, you can, like, you know that he's putting in the work. He's putting in the time. He's having fun with it. He continues to get better. You know, it sucks at the beginning starts that, you know, he played like that. But he looked really good, looked very comfortable. You know, we really were trying to take some of his stuff away from him, and he just kept hitting shot after shot again. You know, credit to him.
Thank you.
Now, can you take us through, like, an open look? I mean, you guys practiced before the game. Some teams, you know, you guys, one of the coaches jumping at you in your face, swish, broomstick, swish, like all these things, easy to make them in practice. But then when you got an open look in a game, is it more difficult? How tough is it to hit, like, open looks? Because it seems like the crowd's like, oh, you're wide open. You should hit this easily. Mm-hmm. How tough is that?
Yeah, it depends. You know, definitely different guys are, you know, handle those differently. You know, I think some players like, you know, believe it or not, for the shots to be contested and not be so open. You know, some guys don't want to catch and shoot straight. They want to be able to put it on the floor. They want to be able to do something to kind of fill it out. It's just the way that it is. But yeah, those open looks, I mean, those are the ones that you want. You know, you want to be able to take them. I personally like them. So take your time, you know, knock it down. And yeah, but I just feel like everyone's different.
Can it be mental where you think about it too much? I got to hit this. I'm wide open. There's no, people are just looking at you. The defense is.
It really shouldn't be. Yeah. You know, it really shouldn't be. But again, maybe, you know, some guys, maybe that is the case. But you shouldn't, you're usually not thinking about that. Usually, you know, this is what I do, catch it, you know, try to knock it down.
And can that be contagious, missing those? Like, it seemed like tonight, a lot of guys had open looks and just didn't go down.
I don't know if it's contagious. You know, for whatever reason, yeah, we were missing him. Yeah, I wouldn't say that's contagious. No.
Wrap it up right there. Thank you, Al.
Thank you.